Hi, it's Bob Kraft of TennisMinistry.org, and today's I'd like to talk about player Maria Sharapova. She's been a well-known player since at least the early 2000s, and I've had a lot of contact with her, and I'd like to share about that. She was at one time the most recognized figure on the internet. When you type in, according to some statistics that they measure that with, when you type in her, more people type in her name than anybody else's in the world. So she had a lot of influence. One thing that I really recognized very early on about Maria Sharapova was that she always wore a cross, a very large cross. It was predominant. It was always in her advertising posters. For example, with Nike, she always had that on. Media interviews. And I knew that her faith played a very important role. It's not uncommon for media for them to take that off for publicity photos, a player, because I think either their manager or the company say, oh, it could offend some people, so we don't want that on. And then they will wear it maybe a cross when they're in their personal life, but in their public life, they will actually not. Maria was different. Maria is the only player that I know who actually has always worn her cross, and it's been very predominantly displayed in ads and so forth. So it's very important to talk about her. She, I met her in the year 2002, and because of that, because I knew that about her, I was able to go up and just talk to her. And I said, I'm a pastor, and she was young at that time. She wasn't I could even say a young woman, as I remember. She was probably a teenager, but she was number one in the world. So she accepted me immediately, what I did and who I was. And her father, what was interesting about that was that her father, who was always within 1 or 2 yards from her, would let me do that. That was very unusual because her father's name is Yuri, he is a tough guy. And he can yell at people easily, he can intimidate people, he can get his way by intimidating people. And in fact, it's not even in a healthy way. So that was a miracle in itself that Yuri would let me go. And I would give Maria books, and I would give her pamphlets, I would sit with her. Yuri would be across the room, he'd pay attention, he'd be doing his thing, but he'd know I was there, and I'd be sitting right next to Maria, and I'd be talking to her or giving her material. So I gave her the daily bread in Russian. I asked her, I said, well, what do you prefer, Russian or English? And she told me English. So, you know, I from then sourced materials in English. And I would give her material. I gave her a purpose-driven life book, and I would always encourage her. Now, because Yuri was, I had to be very careful because, number one, she's number one in the world, and you don't want to offend the number one player because they can go to tournament directors and make a lot of difficulty for you. Number two is that Yuri was always paying attention to what I was doing, so I really had to be careful about overstepping my boundaries. But for that period of time, which was about maybe 3 or 4 or 5, actually I would say at least 5 years, I was able to give Maria material. Now, we couldn't get into discussions about church life, where do you go to church, and so forth and so on. And some ways I regret that I didn't really proceed with more in-depth discussion. But I did the best I could, and in a difficult circumstance. Maria is a very quiet person. She likes to be by herself. She reads books constantly. I remember before she played the finals of the U.S. Open, I was sitting right next to her, and she had this big, thick book, and she was just sitting there reading it. This was before the finals of the match. And she's reading it, and it was like a biography or something. So I was very pleased to see that. She's a quiet person, and she listens to music. Her coach, Michael Joyce, now during that period of time, he was not too supportive of me. I knew him as a player when he played in the 90s. I actually shared the gospel with him at the Hong Kong tournament. But for whatever reason, he wasn't that supportive, didn't really seem to want me around. But I could get around because I was allowed to be around through Yuri. Now, what was very strange about this was in the year 2008 or 9, Michael, who'd worked with Maria for a long period of time, accepted Christ in his life. He had something happen in his family that caused him to cry out to God. And because of that, Michael was born again. And when we sat down, we actually started talking about Christ and faith, and there was fellowship there. And that's going on for a year or two. Now, Michael is no longer the coach, but that was an amazing change that could take place. And Michael was someone that I could go up to and I could ask him, what's the circumstance with the family? And he would share that with me, and confidentially, of course. And then I could go and it would help me know how to approach it better. Now, at the French Open, say in the year 2007 or 8, I went up to Yuri. We were in the transport lounge, and I had some materials. I just happened to have materials in Russian. So I went up to him, and I said, Yuri, would you like to read these? And it could have been because Maria maybe had lost. I really don't know the circumstances. Yuri was famous for being well-known when Maria lost for being a madman with everybody around him. And it could be. I really don't know. But he was really angry at me for doing that. He said, I don't want that material. I don't want that, you know. And from that moment on, it was almost impossible. In fact, I could say impossible for me to be around Maria talking to her. Okay, because Yuri didn't want me around. And also something else took place was that Maria was at the age where she was a young woman and she was starting to pull away from Yuri, which made him very upset. Okay, he was losing in some ways his daughter to womanhood, but he was also losing his ability to influence her, and maybe there were other things that he was concerned about losing, i.e. financial situation. So Yuri became an opponent of the gospel at that point. Maria wasn't easy for me to, I could smile to her, I could say hello to her. I couldn't really give her material at that point. Yuri would work against me. I remember at Wimbledon, 2008 or so, I'm walking down the street going into the Players Lounge, and I just say hi to him, and he screamed at me. He goes, don't talk to me again, you know, like that. And he goes, what could you do? You know, somebody responds like that to you. And he walks by, and I walk by, and that was it. And then he went to the tournament officials and tried to have me banned from the tournament. And the tournament officials came to me and said, no problems. They said, we're just telling you this so that you know it, but you're not creating any problems. And so, you know, these are the kind of difficulties I had to overcome. Now, I was really in some ways pleased, but of course God is in control of all circumstances. When Yuri, all of a sudden Maria stopped Yuri from traveling with her. And during that period of time, there was about a 1 year period where the relationship between he and Maria wasn't all that great. She would do her own thing during the tournaments and he would just be separate, where we never saw that before. I never saw that before. So all of a sudden, Yuri's really become very unimportant with the tournament scene. And he just disappears from the scene. And Maria's by herself. And that continued, that opened up the door that I could actually share. Now, I wasn't able to do it because she wasn't staying in tournaments very long. Her ranking had dropped. She would lose in the first round or second round. The other thing was that she had a period of time where she wasn't playing because of injuries. So I wasn't able, but you know, I planted seeds over that period of 4 or 5 years. And also, I think that she had people around her who accepted Christ, such as her coach, Michael. And, you know, I don't know what influence that had on her, but what I do know is that she, I can honestly say, I feel she's the only player that has publicly shown her faith by the wearing of her cross at all times. She has never taken it off during the entire time I've known her. And I'm thankful for that. And we need to pray for Maria Sharapova. We need to pray for the people around her, for her family situation, and continue to lift her up in prayer and believe that she can find a home church where they will teach the message of Jesus Christ in its fullness, to her and in its love so that she can begin to know more and more about Christ.